Hello, this is my fourth video and the second part because at first it's about the GSM modem connection to a personal computer and getting and sending SMSs through that computer. Now I did this is the fourth video I did. I wanted to explain something about the code behind, something about problems I was I faced while developing the program, and I did all this in about between 30 to 40 minutes, and at the end the program didn't save it somehow. It just saved the beginning. So first I have to say that the problems that you saw on the third or second video about sorting the log SMS messages after you send them, this is fixed already, and the sending to the second person that has a proper and normal cellular phone number is sending right and okay. I send to all the list three times, and all three times it sent to all of them except the first person, which has a like something like 5-digit cellular number, which is not normal. Now, on my last video, I showed a lot of things about the code and many more things, but this time I will make it shorter. I don't want the program to break again and to delete 3/4 of my recording. So I will do it a little bit more, I will be more concise. Let's first, this is, as you know already, you should know, my tools programs. I will double click to make it my taskbar, and I will, without the hotkeys, I will do it manually. Start the RS-232, and I will open the connection, and I will start the Yacht program, which is she has also the option to get calls, cellular calls. Now, before I'll do that, I want to. I'm not sure I told this on the third clip, but this is the optimal speed talking to this hardware with the default settings. Maybe you can change the default settings, but as the default setting, this 57600 baud is the default speed. Less than this, sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. I don't know what exactly changes the communication quality. It can be heat, it can be the cable, it can be the device itself that is some parts on it change with heat, and then it receives or sends the data bits not as it's needed. So this is the speed. Now, as you can see, there is a checkbox, get calls, and if I take it out, this open and close button change to normal control back color. Now the reason for this is that this module, which was first developed back on 2008 and 2009, is while this is checked, it does very preliminary checks on the data that is sent. Every data is going through this module first and then to the other SMS, mass SMS, SMS party, or IPON SMS yacht. Why is that? Because when you get rings, when you get call, you want to get it as soon as possible, and this can be done only with this main module. It should check that there is a ring. It writes on the terminal ring, and I should send it to the main form. From here, I'm sending it to the main form. So this call back caller alerts me that there is something that I will not see here on the terminal, because it does something with the data and I will not see it. While it's not checked, I can see every data that comes from the device. Now, from the hardware. Now, you can ask me why you need this main module, and from here, you call the IPON Yacht, IPON SMS Yacht, or IPON SMS Party. And also, if you notice, the mass SMS program also loads this module itself. Why is that? The reason for that is writing, it's called modular writing. Instead of writing three times the same code for three applets, I am writing here one time, and it serves all three applets. And also, if I want to make a change that is something for some behavior change, some code change for the program, I do it once only, and it serves all three applets. Yes, I don't need to go for each applet and change it. I just have to think that they are using this one and take care about the data for them, and then it serves all three applets. And by itself, it communicates me to the hardware device. By the way, all the computer hierarchy and all this stuff is built in the same modular way. In Microsoft, there are like 5,000 developers, and each works on specific small let's say a cogwheel of a big machine, and each one doesn't know what the other are doing. He concentrates on his work, and but at the end, all the cogwheels are connecting together and working in tandem. This is called, generally it's called object oriented. Like you are working on one object and the other guy is working on another object, and they can mingle together and merge together at the final program. So this is a good practice for writing programs. If I will load the program, it first loads the all the data from the last day, this day and the day before. It loads all this data. Now, last time I gave an example how to get Hebrew from the by this module. I want to say you cannot, I'm not sure I said so, or if I did, I'm sorry. You cannot send Hebrew by this SMS because the two kind of hardwares, the Telit hardware and the SIM900, will change whatever you send. The software is the software will pass the Hebrew, but the hardware will not pass it. But to get the Hebrew, you just have to work with Unicode. That means, for example, 05D0 is in Hebrew Aleph, and 05D1 is in Hebrew Bet, and so on and so forth until you get Tav, and then you have some other letters in Hebrew that are connected to Hebrew, but they are not actually the letters themselves. Many punctuation and auxiliary letters. I will send now a message to this SIM card, and I will write the code 050 whatever is written there. Let's write it 05 and capital D, and then back to 0, and again 05 capital D, and then 1, and I will send it. What I did here is I sent a code, ASCII code. First, you can see over here that there is a SMS just got now, and it's saved on cell number 1. Now we will see this SMS only after the device will finish 21 seconds and 13 more seconds to finish the query. Each 1 minute it queries the device, and the query itself takes time, because if you have 30 messages in SIM 900, or 20 maximum messages with delete, it takes messages are full letters, it takes about maximum 13 seconds to get them. So what I wanted actually to prove is not proved here. I will on my last lecture I sent this code, and Hebrew was displayed, and I'm not sure for now why it didn't. But this is a lecture about teaching code behind and what's going on. So it's okay if it didn't show. Now whatever I wanted, we can find later what's the reason for that. What I wanted to show here, that you can, if you send a code, the software will think you sent Hebrew, but I don't know many people that send this code 05. I think I see the problem. The problem is that I send it with, if you can see, with a space over here. And if you send a code with a space, each Hebrew letter consists four hexadecimal digits from 0 to F. And if it have 5, it means that something is wrong here. It's not, maybe the first four are a Hebrew digit, the Hebrew character, and what about the other one? It's not possible. You must send exactly a modulo of 4, that the modulo, the multiply of 4 will give modulo of 0. Modulo is the reminder. Once the reminder is 0, it means, and you divide it by 4 and the reminder is 0, it means you have a multiplies of 4. Of course, it should be more than 0, more than 4 or more. If you send 0, it doesn't consist any letter. So I will, for example, I will try 05D0. I will send just one letter now. Let's see over here. It will show again SM1. Why it says SM1? It's in cell 1 because this cell was already read before. Now the query of the device, it says, give me all what you got because I deleted everything. And after 6 seconds, the query will finish. And we should see here, you see, as you see, I was correct. I sent only one letter. You see here, Aleph. And that's why, that's because now there is no space, and the program knows that there is such a code, and such a code consists inside a boundary of Hebrew characters. I'm not sure how many characters we have. I think 22. So if it doesn't consist of a Hebrew character, it will show exactly what the SMS sent. But now it has Hebrew. So if you send a whole sentence and even one, and it has a modulo of multiply by 4, modulo while dividing, modulo is 0. It means it multiplied by 4, and all the letters, all every each and four, each letter of the 4 is inside the Hebrew characters. It will show Hebrew, and if it's outside, if there is, let's say, not a modulo of 0, let's say 24, it's okay, divided by 4, but 25, it will never show Hebrew. It will show the exact ASCII characters that were sent. Or if it's, let's say, 24 characters, but each one of the 4 characters is not is not I forgot the word, I'm sorry. represented, that's the word, is not representing a Hebrew character, is not representing a Hebrew character, so it means you will see English only, because one of the four characters does not represent Hebrew. Another thing I want to say, any of my videos until now, and by this I will finish this video, I'm not sure I will do another one, as the reasons were given at the beginning, I don't write any notes on the side of my computer, and either I don't write any notes inside the computer or something that will help me think what to say. The reason for that is that I want to all the time to be concentrated and come with the list at my head and not be rely on a list that is written, and like I'm small-headed with and I read everything that is written from the beginning. No, I want to force my brain to think and to bring the word online at the moment, let's say live words, and without a list that is pre-written. Wrote from the beginning. Thank you very much for watching.